It's been a real privilege to be here tonight and to sign with you the strategic partnership between balance and potential. So thank you for that. We've been a distributor for CPP for Thailand and Vietnam for coming up 4 years now. CPP very well, and therefore we understood their strategy, their tools, and they particularly were keen to find a partner who they felt shared the same passion for MBTI and its application. We've been using MBTI extensively through some of our other companies, particularly in terms of coaching and team development. So it was a natural progression for us to take on the distributorship when we were asked.
Did you do the MBTI test before for yourself?
Oh yes, I did it many years ago.
Yeah. So is it accurate
to
yourself?
Extremely accurate. I'm an ENTP. It's a good question. MBTI is really about your natural preferences. And because of the environment, the way we grow up, the experiences we have, the times we're forced to modify and do things out of our preferences. And that can confuse us at times. But our fundamental preferences never change. So if we really think about it, then the accuracy of those preferences is extremely high.
So is there any place that the result of MBTI test is different from any
other school? Well, in general, no. But some people do get confused because they've been forced into an environment that's totally inconsistent with their preferences. And they have to learn how to modify behaviours within that environment. So sometimes they get confused about the answer to questions, not so much about natural preferences, but more about the way they're being guided on other behaviours. But when they're released from that and they can concentrate on their natural preferences, then absolutely accurate.
As I tell you
before,
I mean, this will be used as
in the past, it came about because there wasn't an official version of it in Vietnam. Same situation in Thailand. Because there was no official version of it, then obviously people fill up the vacuum, if you like, or the need through other ways. We've found that once the official versions are available, then the serious companies, serious users, serious universities and schools, they're more interested in that kind of fake versions, because you need people that are qualified and certified in understanding how to use MBTI, and you also want a lot more depth out of the MBTI reports than you get through the fake versions. So companies, for instance, in Thailand now, that use MBTI, they don't use the fake versions because they don't get the KPI from the project by using them. They go to the official version. So I think you'll find a similar outcome that once you have the official versions available, once you have people like you, like the balance team, able to fully implement it and help people get benefit, then I think the compelling value of the audience.